the Donkey FCB and welcome back here to the channel, guys. And let's get straight down to business here, because this video is exactly what it says on the tin. We are going to be breaking down Frenkie de Jong's stunning goal against Real Betis and how, for me, that really does show all of the fundamentals of Quique Setién's way of playing. What we saw in that goal was movement, elegance, we saw risk in our passing, we saw cutting edge intensity, and I'm going to be walking you through exactly how that goal took place. And of course, there's brilliance from Messi, there's brilliance from De Jong, but that goal for me, it was all about the team, it was all about the shape, and all about that way of playing under Setién that I believe can take Barcelona back to the very top. It's all coming up in today's video. Let's do it! Because I think sometimes there are a lot of false theories about the way that Setién does want to play. A lot of people believe that Setién has a lot of meaningless possession, but actually, it's not meaningless at all. You look at the goal, that first goal that we're going to discuss, there was 9 passes in total. It wasn't just pass, 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 pass. At times you may see that, but it's all about working the opposition, trying to create that space, and when we see it, we will go for the jugular. There were 7 passes there, inside our own half, just back and forth waiting. But then there was just 2 passes there, cutting through the opposition in the opposing half. That's what we'll see under Setién. There will be possession, there will be more of it, but we will also see that cutting edge, as I'm going to show you now. Because as is often the case with Barcelona, we start right here with the goalkeeper, Marc-André Ter Stegen. And as you can see here, all he's doing is waiting. And a lot of people sometimes think, you know, why doesn't he release the ball? Why doesn't he here start the attack sooner? Sometimes Barcelona, especially now under Setién, they will actually invite the press. And although that sounds strange, because often you think about teams pressing as high as a bad thing, but actually, if you can get around it, if you've got a plan in place there to break down that press, it's not such a bad thing at all. If you've got the confidence there of the players in that back line to find a way around it, that is not a problem at all. And that's why Ter Stegen here, he's inviting that press. You can see there he's going to play it sideways to Samuel Umtiti. And you can see there Betis are getting ready to pounce. Samuel Umtiti then receives the ball from Ter Stegen, and he's going to shift it there to his other centre-back partner, Clement Longley. And one thing here, one massive thing that I've got to highlight right throughout this goal is all about first touch. Because you watch here the touch of Clement Longley, and you also observe here the touch, the first touch of Frenkie de Jong. They're both fantastic. They are what makes this goal and what makes this move. Because you look here, the ball is coming across the body of Clement Longley. Now, if he takes the first touch inside him on his instep, he then is in a bad body position, and all he's going to have to do there is go back to Umtiti. But no, Longley there lets the ball come across him. He makes a nice first touch, and he sets the ball brilliantly in one touch there to play it nicely down the line. That's exactly what he needed to do, and that is the sign there of a very good ball-playing centre-back. Longley then can see the pass, he can see the passing angle there to Frenkie de Jong, but executing that pass and actually having there the confidence to take that on, I think that's something else. Because I believe here, under Ernesto Valverde, we wouldn't have seen that pass. It would have been treated as far, far too high risk. And yeah, it is a very risky ball. Believe me, Emerson was close to cutting it out, Real Betis there had bodies around us, it could have ended badly. But that's what it's all about. We are a team who do take risks. The bigger the risk, the higher the reward. And that's what Barcelona will see under Quique Setién. Longley there plays that ball into Frenkie de Jong, and now it's about his first touch. Because again, he could there take the first touch facing his own goal. And if he does that, that ball then is only going to go back. But he doesn't do that. Instead, he lets the ball there run across his body. He doesn't even touch the ball. He lets all the pace on the ball do the work, and it's wonderfully, wonderfully done. He lets all of that ball do the work, and suddenly, his first touch is here. He's away there from his marker, and now he's advancing into all that space. So it's really, really good understanding there from Longley to play it into De Jong, but also good understanding from De Jong to realise there, there's space in behind him. If I let this ball go through me, if I can actually run onto it there, I've got all that space. And that's called there, being aware of your surroundings. That's another good sign of a very, very good midfielder. Now De Jong has opened up the pitch. He's got Griezmann here, stretching things to the left. Good width there from Antoine Griezmann. And then he's got Messi, who's taken up position on the right-hand side. But I also want to keep an eye on here, Arturo Vidal. He is very, very important in in this goal. De Jong, as we know there, switches it out to Lionel Messi. Now keep a very, very close eye there on the run of Arturo Vidal, and then the run of De Jong, who's actually there going to make that late run as a midfielder, whereas Vidal is actually going to make the run of a centre forward. And that's what I mean about having a presence on the field there of technically a number nine, because what they're going to do there, they're going to occupy that space there in between the two centre backs and just really take all the attention away from De Jong, who's going to make that emerging run. And of course there, when Lionel Messi's got the ball, you know that if you make that run into that space, he will find you. And as you can see here, Griezmann has a marker. Arturo Vidal has a marker. They're both taking up good positions there. They're both occupying defenders. De Jong, though, has a marker, but he's going to get away from him. And when he does that, nobody's going to track him because they've already got men. And that's what it's about there, having players in that final third who may not be actually making runs there to get onto a ball, but they are occupying defenders, taking the attention away so that those from deep can make those runs. And like I say, if you make that run, Lionel Messi is guaranteed to find you. It's a wonderful, wonderful pass. It's weighted perfectly. De Jong is absolutely incredible in the timing of his run. And of course then, it's all down to that individual quality. And De Jong, for me, in terms of his attacking play, he's developing as a player. It's a brilliant first touch on his chest. He doesn't panic. He brings it down. He could have easily handballed that, but he didn't. And it's a wonderful, wonderful first time finish into the back of the net. And that, for me, best Barcelona goal that we've seen this season from the team. And I really do believe that, because like I say there, you're seeing the build-up, you're seeing Ter Stegen involved, you're seeing the centre-backs, you move it into midfield, you completely bypass there the press, the very high press of Betis, you're into the opposition third, and then it's very, very decisive, very calculated play, and a brilliant, brilliant finish. That, for me, epitomises everything that Quique Setién is about. And as these players understand their roles more, as we get those runs absolutely right, you'll see much more of this happening, much more space opening up, and believe me, we have the players to capitalise. And I particularly enjoyed the celebrations of the man himself on the sidelines. He couldn't even hide, and he's quite a calm guy on the sideline, Quique Setién, but even he couldn't hide there the real enthusiasm and excitement when that goal went in. Because think about it there from his point of view, he's watching there essentially his work coming into action. Those players there are bringing his ideas to life, and he must be incredible there, standing on the sidelines, watching those top-class professionals take on your instructions and make it all happen. He has here a wonderfully gifted group of players that he knows how to work, he knows how to make it all come together, and I still believe inside me, real, real hope and enthusiasm towards this Barca team. We are certainly moving in the right direction. And the final point here in today's video, guys, aside from that goal, one thing that I haven't really touched on after the game, I think it's really, really interesting actually to watch the difference there in Barcelona in the last third of that game and Real Betis. Bearing in mind that we played just a few days before that game, we played a really, really hard game against Athletic Club on the Thursday. We were then back in action in a tough, tough game on the Sunday. Did we look more tired? I don't think so. I think Betis looked the more tired team, and they had the entire week off. And I just don't see that happening under Valverde. I didn't see the team with that kind of physical conditioning, and given as well the very limited resources we have right now in the first team. And again, that's down to Setién and the training and the constant demand there to get these players perfectly up to speed. And again, as the season goes on, you will see that getting better and better and better. We can wear teams down, we can work them, we can try and force them out of their shape and make them run. And we're going to start to see not Barca tiring on the field, but actually the opposition. And that's the way that it should be. That's the way that many of us have watched Barcelona break down teams over the years. That's how it works. And it's nice now to be getting back to those foundations. And hopefully, there's plenty more to come. And so that does indeed bring us to an end in today's video, guys. But of course now, as we start to look ahead to the weekend's fixtures, Barcelona against Getafe now is on the horizon. That's our full focus. And I want to bring you here some big news from today's training session, because there have been concerns, of course, about our centre-back pairing going into this weekend. Clement Lenglet sent off there against Real Betis. He's going to be suspended. And right now, it's uncertain as to whether Piqué and Umtiti will be ready. One thing that I can tell you is that today, Piquet returned to train with the group. He was absolutely fine, went through that training session. He should be fine for the weekend. But the same right now can't definitively be said about Samuel Umtiti. He today didn't train with the group. He only did specific work on his own. And it remains to be seen whether he's going to be fit in time with Araujo waiting if we need him. But of course, guys, all the build-up to that game will be coming to you in the coming days. I still believe, of course, we can get a good result and continue this good momentum. Please leave your thoughts on Frankie's goal and everything we've learned from Setien's Barca so far in the comments down below. I will see you soon, of course. Thank you for your support. But until next time, as always, Visca El Barca!